Nina. Thanks for joining me today for another video. Now that we've hit the new year, I know a lot of us are trying to hit our goals for the upcoming year. So one of the things I always love starting off the new year with is organizing. I love starting fresh for the new year, getting my craft room completely organized, and just feeling really well set for the upcoming crafting year. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing 5 different products that I'm using from Simon Says Stamp to help organize myself for my crafting. I love being able to utilize products to better help make myself have a better time crafting, and so I can find things easier, I can utilize them better, and I wanted to share the products that I'm using to help me do that. So I have a whole assortment of items here on my desk that I'm going to be sharing with you today. And the first one I want to start off with is our Simon Says Stamp Clear Cardstock Storage Sleeves. So these are a great size for 8.5 by 11 cardstocks. And one of my favorite things to put into these cardstock sleeves are specialty papers. And you can see here they fit quite a few sheets. I would say on average, you can probably get anywhere between 15 to 20 sheets inside of each cardstock storage sleeve, but of course it will always depend on how thick your cardstock is. I've also used this for some of our holographic rainbows cardstock and also our white glossy cardstock, which is a really great staple for a variety of card projects, including die cutting and foiling. One of the great features about these storage sleeves is the fact that they are really easy to pull cardstock in and out of because of that nice rounded edge that's on the front of the pocket. So this is a great way to be able to organize your cardstock and keep it nice and safe while you're crafting. In addition to those cardstock storage sleeves, I also really love the pockets. So we have our Simon Says Stamp Positively Everything Storage Pockets, which have a little notch cut into them so that you can tuck the flap of the pocket into that notch and keep everything contained inside. These are great for not just our watercolor cards, but you can also put sentiment strips inside of these. And I've shared these ideas in the past, but in addition to those particular products, I also love putting my sticker gems inside of these pockets. So I have little sticker sheets filled with gems inside of each individual pocket, and that can let me organize each of these sticker sheets by company or product name, and that way I know exactly where they came from. Then I have them all tucked inside of our Positively Everything Clear boxes. These are great for not just holding the pockets, but I love putting product inside of these boxes. So in one of my boxes, I actually store sequins inside of it. And you can see I can fit a ton of our Simon Says Stamp sequins inside of these boxes. So it's really great for helping me contain all those little baggies. I can stuff them all inside of the box and then just grab one of the baggies that I want to use for my card project. But they're all contained, and of course it looks really colorful in my studio, so I love having all that color showing through so I can actually see what's inside. It's one of the great features about having these as clear boxes. But in addition to all of these other things that I've already shared with you, one of the ways I love using these boxes is by keeping my Copic marker refills organized. Copic marker refills are a very hard product for me to be able to store. And I have found that these boxes hold a ton of refills. And I can sort them by color. I've made labels so that way I know exactly which colors are inside of each box. And this way I can keep them all organized. I can easily grab the Copic color refill that I want without having to dig through an entire box full of refills. I have it organized in a way that I can easily find them. Now I don't have refills for all of my Copic markers, so that's why I have multiple colors mixed into each box. But if you have a lot more refills, you could totally fill each individual box with one color. So one box might be full of red, another box might be full of pink, another one with yellow, and so on and so forth. So besides the boxes, another thing I love having handy in my craft room are the Simon Says Stamp blending brush holders. Now, of course, that tells you automatically that this is a great storage solution for blending brushes. And you can see that's what I use one of the blending brush holders that I have for. But in addition to that, I also like using my blending brush holder for other things. So I have multiple blending brush holders in my craft room, and one of them I have actually filled with Karen markers. I love using these for watercoloring, and this holds the markers super well. This is a silicone insert inside of a plastic container, so that means it's going to grip the surface of the marker really, really well, and the markers aren't going to fall out easily. Now, in addition to using it for markers, you could also use it for tools too. In this image here, you can see that it's filled with a variety of scissors, craft picks, bone folder, paintbrushes, you name it. Any sort of tools will work really well inside of these blending brush holders. So just because they're called blending brush holders doesn't mean that that's what you have to use them for. So keep that in mind. This is a really versatile tool, and I've been using it in so many places inside my craft room. I actually could use another one. Now, I don't know about you, but I always have random things floating around in my craft room. And I really love having the Simon Says Stamp mesh bags to help me contain all that clutter that ends up piling up somewhere. So one of the mesh bags actually I use to hold projects that I've started but then never finished. I don't know about you, but I always have stuff that I planned on using for a card and then I changed my mind and now I have all these pieces that I never finished using that I want to save. I don't want to throw them out. So I actually store all those in a mesh bag. In addition to that, I also use mesh bags for helping me organize my card kits. So Simon Says Stamp has our monthly card kits that we release every single month, and I love being able to keep them sorted by each individual month. So that way, if I want to go back and use all the contents from the kit, I already have it all together. I don't have to figure out where I put everything. So I love that these mesh bags are so deep and sturdy and large enough to be able to hold all those pieces. And because they're flexible, they can even hold bulky items that are included in the kit, such as the Glitz Glitter Gel that was part of the January 2021 card kit. So these mesh bags I have found to be super helpful for helping me organize my products, but also help keep the clutter contained inside of my craft room. I find stacking these up in my IKEA cart or other containers is a really great way to be able to help hold stuff together, but also keep it nice and tidy. So all of these ideas are using products from our Simon Says Stamp organization collection. You can find all these products over at our Simon Says Stamp store. I have them linked below in the video description if you're interested in any of them. And if you'd love to see some pictures about how I use these in my craft room, be sure to check out the Simon Says Stamp blog post for additional photos so you can see exactly where I'm using them. Thanks so much for stopping by and watching this video. I appreciate it so very much. If you enjoyed, please be sure to give the video a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I'll be back soon with more to share. But until I see you all again, I hope everyone has a very wonderful day. Bye!